Hey, welcome back to the shop. This is Zach over at NB Woodworks. So today I wanted to kind of share a quick tip, and I'm going to make this kind of a new little series on my channel. Today's quick tip has to do with mixing cups. Now, you know, I got these different kind of paint mixing cups. I get these 10-ounce ones at Wood & Whimsies. I found these 16-ounce mixing cups on Amazon. Everybody kind of knows these quart size. Typically, to be honest, I just use these solo cups. I find them to be the cheapest. And, you know, you can get a big bag of them, everything's good. Now, the thing that I want to talk about, though, is reusing these. After a while, cups get pretty expensive, and you sure as heck don't want to be tossing out these paint mixing cups. So, what I found to be the easiest way to reuse these, or to clean them up, let's say, depends on what I'm doing here, but let's say that I'm mixing Alumilite, and a lot of times, if I'm doing the clear, I usually just pour it into one cup, A and B. The white, if I'm coloring the part A, I will always put part B and part A in separate cups and then mix them. So let's just say that this was Alumilite white and I was dyeing one side and I had to get a specific amount. So I'm going to put part A in this one, part B in this one. After I've added my dye and, you know, then I dump them together and start mixing them up, dump it into the mold, one of these cups is going to have part A and part B. It's going to be resin that's already mixed. That cup, to reuse it, the easiest way, I just set it down, walk away, and let it cure in that cup overnight. This other cup that only had part A or part B or whatever in it, that one obviously is not going to cure or anything. So what you can do is you can actually just wash it with acetone. Wash it out real good, dry it, and you can reuse that cup. Now, for the mixing cups, the paint mixing cup kind of cups, that works really good, and again, these are kind of expensive, so you want to reuse them if you can. Eventually, you might get a crack, or you know, you may have to throw them away. But these things work really good for this because they're usually very flat on the sides. There's no ridges or any embellishments on it, so this works excellent in these paint mixing cups. And you know, definitely don't just use those things once and throw them away. Now, what happens is after it's, you know, overnight, let's say it's set up and cured in the cup, pretty much now you might need to kind of peel it away. Here's a kind of an example. Now, I did already pop this out. It won't always just come out that easy, but this is what I get. Now, this was probably a pretty big pour right here, but you'll notice that it's very thin on the walls. A lot of people take the time to actually pour very thin layers to do ribbon blanks. Well, if you save these little guys, and again, this is a pretty big one. You're not usually going to be using a quart cup, but you still get the same ribbons, and I've been saving the ones out of these 10 ounces and in the solo cups as well. I've been cutting them out. Now, the bottom's pretty thick usually, but I just cut this stuff out on the sides, throw them in a drawer, and I save them. And so I haven't tried it yet, but as far as I'm concerned, this will be pretty good ribbon material. Thanks for watching this quick tip. So if you have any questions, I'd like to hear also from you. If you use this, if you have any better ideas for reusing cups, let me know. But you can leave comments down below. You can email me at zach@nvwoodworks.com if you have any questions or anything like that. I always like trying to help out, or you know, just see what projects you're working on. If you got any submissions for viewer photos for the weekly updates, definitely email them to me, or you can just hit me up on Facebook or Twitter. I'm at NV Woodworks on Twitter, and I'm NV Woodworks on Facebook. You can like my Facebook page over there. And yeah, so I hope this was helpful, and I hope it wasn't that long, but I kind of had to explain what was going on in this one. The future ones, I'm gonna really try and cut them to 2 to 3 minutes and get it in there, get it out, and share a tip. So I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.